So how do we go about implementing the ISO 27001? So the very first step is to define the context establishment. So in that is to first be able to understand what the organization is all about. Where are your key businesses or core businesses areas? Without understanding what that is, you will not be able to find out what it is that you need to protect. So different organizations will have different values for information. So it's important for you to first identify what are the organizational businesses, and then what are the information that you are actually collecting, and then what are you going to do with the information, and hence the value of that information to you. And then from there to look at what are the needs and the expectations of interested parties. So in today's age, many companies are actually looking at outsourcing of the managing of their information. Now, outsourcing of the management of the information does not necessarily mean that it's the outsourcing of the ownership of that information. So important for an organization when you look at what you are trying to protect is to understand what is the expectations of those in requirement. And then
we'll just wait a moment to see.
Yeah, sure. The streaming stopped or?
Yeah, the stream, we're back on.
Good. I'm not sure where I stopped though. leadership, but should I
go
just
back
start
to leadership? Yeah.
Start it again? Or?
Yep, we can start again.
Yep. Okay, in terms of getting leadership commitment into this project, and which is why I earlier said that it's really important to take ISMS as a project, because to ensure that you get the traction that you need, to ensure that it gets a successful implementation at the end of the day, it's really important to get the leadership's view into this. So one of the ways that we've actually done that in terms of implementing that is to define organizational roles and responsibility. We start creating or establishing and defining what an information security organizational structure would look like to make sure that the information security officer have a prominent role within the organization, and then outlining what those responsibilities of everyone within the information security organizational structure. By that method, where you then have them signed off at the very top level, that's where we actually said that that's how you get leadership's commitment right from the top in itself. And that's really important if you want to see a successful implementation of an ISMS. And then the next part from that is then to look at how do we then start implementing some of the concepts of information security. Now, where we said earlier, 27001 is actually a risk-based approach into managing information security. Hence, obviously, a big part of that is in terms of planning out how do we actually manage the ISMS as a risk-based approach. So in this part of the implementation, it's about coming up with a risk management framework. It's about coming up with risk acceptance criteria. So to what extent are you acceptance of a particular risk in the organization? And to what level do you want to make sure that actions are actually undertaken? Now, the other thing also about risk management is that it allows you to prioritize on the controls that you want to put in place. So ultimately, what a risk management framework is should be able to assist an organization to do is to filter down from close to 114 controls potentially that you need to implement to perhaps just half of that, depending on the prioritization, depending on the maturity of the organization, depending on what the risk acceptance criteria is. So all these needs to be planned out before you actually then start that process. And similarly, like any other projects implementation that you have, once you've got all your plan in place, that means having a context of the organization, understanding where information is, the value of the information, who are interested in it, having an organizational structure in place, plan out a risk management framework, and then the next thing you need to look at, who are the people who will be involved in that project? Who do I need to have in this project? So obviously for information security project, you need to have people who are, if not well-versed with information security, but to a certain extent would understand the implications of a risk. Now, the importance of that is that when you do a risk management process in itself, the ultimate game of it is to be able to understand those risks that have been identified, to understand the risk that you are accepting for either not accepting, not doing anything about a particular risk, or to implement controls to that, you need to sign that off. So it is important that whoever is in those roles, the information security roles, which are defined at the outstart when you did the organizational structure, is to make sure that they are at least have a basic understanding of what information security is and what risk means to the organization. And finally, is the final part of it is actually to operationalize the whole process in itself. So in this initial phase of the roadmap is to first do the setup of the expectations, and then to plan up what are the frameworks that you need to have in place, and then the next step is obviously to operationalize the implementation in itself. To the next one. So towards the end of that implementation, so on a yearly basis, what needs to happen is that one of the things that needs to be looked into is to build what we call key risk indicators or key performance indices, to enable the monitoring of the project in itself, to look at whether you are behind time, or maybe there are certain risks that have been highlighted during the risk management process phase that needs to be brought up and immediate action needs to be taken, or are we actually coming to a point where our budgets have not been enough and you need to revisit that as well. So the monitoring and the measurement phase of it allows you to manage the project to ensure that you get a successful return at the end of the day. And once you've actually put all this in place, you need to have an assessment of how well you are doing in accordance to what you have actually planned to do. Thanks.